Hello Edward, là mình đã tìm đi. Trời ơi. Lá sẵn. Trời ơi. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is episode 7, I think. And you're probably wondering, Pearl, why are you wearing a coat? Is it winter already in Lesotho? It might as well be to me. So guys, I am one of the unlucky women who experienced dysmenorrhea, which I hope I'm getting it right. It's like heavy, menorrhea is heavy period flow. I don't know if dysmenorrhea means with cramps. But I have really terrible cramps. I have really terrible period cramps. My flow is not always heavy, but one thing that's constant is my period cramps. And the last 2 days haven't been so great for me. So usually I combat the pain, the cramps, with like always keeping warm. So I decided to put on a coat. I'm wearing a coat and my sundress. It's quite light, so if I feel hot, I'll just like put the coat on my shoulders or something. But one thing's for sure, two things for certain, I'm not walking around with just the sundress. And then if I get like even a whiff of just like a cool breeze, I'm back to writhing in pain. I'm not doing that to myself. So one day I'm gonna talk about periods, guys. One day I'm gonna have a discussion about periods. Like, I need to know if my fellow female subbies experience similar things as I do, because wow, it's not fun this site. It's Saturday morning, Sabbath morning. I'm getting ready to go to church. I didn't make an introduction, guys. Welcome back to Pearl's Diary, where we vent, vlog, and venture into different spheres of my life. Yeah. If you're new here, like I've always been saying, darling, we are all new here. We're all new. We're all babies here. But if you've been here since day one, love you. Love you loads. I love all of you, but my day one subbies, my cyclists, let's while. You know, guys, speaking of periods and cramps and whatever, so last night I called my mom. It was not yet. Yeah, it was like around 6 p.m. I called my mom and I was updating her about my cramps and everything. And my mom's a nurse, so if I feel like there's some health alarm, medical alarm, I contact her first. So she's a nurse clinician. So I called her and I was explaining these symptoms and like new things I'm seeing and stuff. And then my dad, my mom's on a call with me. And I can hear him in the back going, "Oh, kipel." And I'm like, "Oh, bye, dad. Bye, mom." Fine. As soon as I end the call with my mom, guess who calls? That this means like, "Hey, go to school. Wait a minute. Get all that." Guys, I promise you, ever since I moved out, my dad will find any reason to take me back home. Like, I am convinced now that he's not going to take it well when I get married. Like, I am so convinced, Jorge, the day I get married is not going, it's going to be probably the saddest day of my dad's life, because he will no longer have an opportunity to have me around the house. I'm actually quite surprised, because I thought Mutana Tronka, like me moving out, bad, or like someone who's gonna, I thought of the two of my parents, yo. Slungu, sent up. What am I trying to say? I'm trying to say, I thought my mom would be the one who'd take me moving out, not so well. But the thing for me is just, yeah, he's not handling it well. He's not handling it great. I mean, he'll pretend he's cool. He'll be like, yes, move out. You learn how well about you. He'll be like, hi, can we do it? Can we do it? So do I. Tell on a lot. I get to know about Langhak, and I'm like, sir, are you not the one who insisted I go home and sleep over because I have period pains? But anyway, guys, before I get late, let me go to church, guys. I see you. Oh yeah, this is not gonna be a weekly vlog. It's going to be just a vlog because probably the next time I talk to you guys, it will probably be on Thursday. I don't have much going on this week, but I will have something going on Thursday, and then we're gonna have a long weekend, like an Easter weekend. I'm going to vlog that as well, so we might as well call this an Easter vlog. And this is my pre-Easter intro. So I'll see you guys on Thursday. Morning, guys. Hi, guys. I know I said the next time I'd speak to you guys would be on Thursday. And I was very intentional about that. I meant every word. But I just woke up. It's Sunday morning. I just woke up and I just did my devotional. Like I told you guys, I'm currently reading. Okay, the lighting is horrible. I'm currently reading The Desire of Ages, guys. There we go. Yay. Able. Gosh. Oh my gosh. Wow. A sign that I need a camera. Anyway, I am currently reading The Desire of Ages by Miss Ellen G. White. First of all, I was currently praying for the Holy Spirit to calm me down. I'm not happy. I am not happy. And you know what? I'm going to use my platform, my vlog, to call out some of these Adventists. I am not happy with some of these Adventists, like the way they portray Miss Ellen G. White. I think it's a Lesotho Adventist thing because I was having a conversation with this guy who's in SA and is also an Adventist, and he was like, every time when I tell him the misconceptions here about like Ellen G. White or like women in the Bible or how women are supposed to conduct themselves, he was always just like, we're talking about the Proverbs 31 woman. He was just like, what? They say what? So just from that conversation, I am thinking it's a Lesotho Adventist men thing. I am gonna highlight men because growing up, and by growing up I mean like as a young youth, if that makes sense, like 11, 12, 13, 14 at youth camps, there were older men, like not bontate, but like some were bontate, but like even older young men who would just present the spirit of prophecy and the writings of Ellen G. White so warped. Like after presentations, I want to just be like, nah, I'm good. I'm not gonna read her books. Nah. If that's what she says we should do. So me, I told you guys, Jorge, my dad encouraged, I almost said three thought. My dad encouraged free thought growing up. So every single thing that is presented and said to me, I will analyze it with zero fear because that's how I was raised. I will analyze it, I will think about it, I will break it down, and if it makes no sense to me, I'll just be like, nah, I'm good. I'm just not, it's not giving. Or if it seems
warped, man. Like it seems unpalatable. Like, so that is how LNG White was presented to me. I spent a really a vast or a significant part of my young youth just not interested until very recently when I read started reading. What is going on? I just woke up, guys. I just woke up and I don't know. But anyway, I started reading The Desire of Ages. Just a young disclaimer though. My dad has a lot of books that are Miss Ellen G. White, so he would read some of them in the morning. He says devotional. I remember we would read The Great Controversy. I don't know why I didn't think of The Great Controversy when these presentations were then made at camps and stuff. Something was just, yeah. I don't know why I didn't think of The Great Controversy. I don't know. Young minds, guys, like, honestly, if a young person who is encouraged to have free thought just hears something, you immediately rubbish it and you don't like. Yeah, I just didn't think about like the great, because I enjoyed The Great Controversy, even though it was read to me. I was moved by it. But also I think it was also coming from an ignorant place. Just like I threw the baby with the bathwater, basically is what I'm saying. But the way it was presented to me definitely was wrong. 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 Here's why I'm gonna say it was wrong. When something is presented to you, like the spirit of prophecy, we're talking about the spirit of prophecy, and you're told to seclude yourself from the world because we are not of the world, or we're not worldly. Seclude yourself from the world, go live in the mountains, shun the cities. There's no good person in the city, and what. So my interpretation of that is like, okay, so if you're not Adventist, you're a horrible. Hey guys, okay, my storage space was running out, so I needed to sort that out. A sign that I need to get a camera and like more equipment. So pray with me, guys. But I was on the topic of like the spirit of prophecy and the writings of Miss Ellen G. White, how they're portrayed to us. Well, how they were portrayed to me as a young girl, that just put me off. I felt like the general message that I was being told or given to was ostracize yourself from the world, remove yourself from the world, be aloof from the world. Like the world is not a good place. There's no good person in the cities, and what. Basically, don't socialize, don't talk to those people, don't be friends with those people, don't. So generally the message I got was, if he ain't Adventist, if she ain't Adventist, she not your friend, stay away. I don't know, that just rubbed me off the wrong way. Like I told you, my dad encouraged free thought. He encouraged questions, he encouraged free thought. So now we can, I wasn't I my parents didn't raise me to ostracize myself from people. Yes, I'm introverted, don't get me wrong. Something my father still doesn't understand, Lona Chinana, because he's always like, make friends, Pearl, talk to people. Even after I moved out, he said, have you made friends with your neighbors? Do you talk to your neighbors? Why aren't you talking to your neighbors? Make friends with your. So I grew up in that household. So when I'm now being told to ostracize myself from people because they're not of my belief, it's like, but that's not the message of love, and the God I know is love. I just want to read a couple of paragraphs that moved me, and hopefully will move some of these people who warp the writings of Miss Ellen G. White and interpret them wrongly, and then like present these warped messages to Adventists and like Christians. Oh, my arm, guys. My arm hurts. Okay.
So this is from page 150, The Desire of Ages. It is the third paragraph, depending on how you look at it. So it says, the ministry of Christ was marked in contrast to that of the Jewish elders. Their regard for tradition and formalism had destroyed all real freedom of thought or action. They lived in continual dread of defilement to avoid contact with the unclean. Unclean in quotation mark, with the unclean, they kept aloof, not only from the Gentiles, but from the majority of their own people, seeking neither to benefit them nor to win their friendship. By dwelling constantly on these matters, they had dwarfed their minds and narrowed the orbit of their lives. Their example encouraged egotism and intolerance among all classes of people. So again, like I said, this chapter is called At the Marriage Feast. Basically, Ellen G. White was recounting the events of, Christ's attendance at the wedding feast. So I'm gonna get to that in a bit, right? I wanna read another paragraph. It says, God had directed John the Baptist to dwell in the wilderness, that he might be shielded from the influence of the priests and rabbis. Not Gentiles. Just say, just pointing that out. And be prepared for a special mission. But the austerity and isolation of his life were not an example for the people. John himself had not directed his hearers to forsake their former duties. He bade them give evidence of their repentance by faithfulness to God in the place where he had called them. And then I'm moving on to the next paragraph. Jesus reproved self-indulgence in all its forms, yet he was social in his nature. Listen, what this said to me was, Pearl, yes, you're introverted, but branch out, try to be more social. Try to be more social. If you want to live a Christ-like life, be a social person by nature. But it also said to me, this whole message, yeah, ostracizing yourself from people because they're not of the same faith. Is it the message of love? Do we need to reevaluate that message? I'm just saying, guys. And on that point, this segment of this vlog, I'm calling out some of my fellow Adventists in love. This whole thing of calling back to Bafilista, this whole thing of calling non-Adventists Bafilista. Just remember the sentence. Their example encouraged egotism, and intolerance amongst all classes of people. Y'all better watch the words you say when you address people who are of a different faith than yours. Because we serve a God who is love. Every single thing you say to a fellow human being should be out of love. This whole thing of calling people Bafilista, honestly, I've never liked it. Anyway, okay, and now I want to read the last paragraph in page 151 of the same book, The Desire of Ages. It says, Jesus saw in every soul one to whom must be given the call of his kingdom. He reached the hearts of people by going among them as one who desired their good. He sought them in the public streets, in private houses, on the boats, in the synagogues, by the shores of the lake, and at the marriage feast. He met them at their daily vocations and manifested an interest in the secular affairs. I'm gonna get to that in a bit. He carried his instructions into the household, bringing families in their own homes under the influence of his divine presence. His strong personal sympathy helped to win hearts. He often repaired to the mountains for solitary prayer, but this was a preparation for his labor among men in active life. From these seasons, he came forth to relieve the sick, to instruct the ignorant, and to break chains from the captives of Satan. So now there's a reason to put yourself in solitude. In preparation for active work with men. So Christ didn't isolate himself from people. He went into solitude to meditate in preparation of his active life, his social life with men. You know, when I was reading this, I said to myself, Ntsirebala deserve ages as Hanan. Ntsirebala spirit of prophecy as Hanan. Am I reading the wrong book? Because when these things were presented to me, I didn't get this message. You guys will correct me if I'm wrong, if I misunderstood you guys, if I misinterpreted you guys. Because, hey, no guys, no. I think we need to repent from, we need to evaluate whose example we're following, Christ or the Jewish elders of that time. My camera is moving about because my hand is tired of holding up this phone. Okay, so I also want to read page 152, the second paragraph. The example of Christ in linking himself with the interests of humanity should be followed by all who preach his word and by all who have received the gospel of his grace. We are not to renounce social communion. We should not seclude ourselves from others. In order to reach all classes, we must meet them where they are. They will seldom seek us of their own accord. I didn't read the full paragraph. And then I want to read the last sentence of that paragraph. And it says, okay, no, let me just read the whole paragraph because it's just going to confuse you if I read that last sentence. It says, not alone from the pulpit are the hearts of men touched by divine truth. There's another field of labor, humbler it may be, but fully as promising. It is found in the home of the lowly, in the mansion of the great, at the hospitable board, and in gatherings for innocent social enjoyment. Innocent social enjoyment. Now this one speaks to my fellow liberals in church. And it also spoke to me, okay, you know what? No more clubbing, no more groove. That's not a social gathering. That's not a social innocent gathering. Yeah, innocent social enjoyment, a gathering of innocent social environment. But I will go to like markets and stuff because there's innocent social gatherings I want to believe. But my whole point is, you see, that whole gatherings for innocent social enjoyment, Miss Ellen G. White highlights on that or emphasizes or talks about that in the context of Christ attending the wedding feast. You know, Christ met people where they are, not just geographically, but also in terms of their interests. But lifting, don't take it too far and then say you're going to evangelize Labo. Because that's not a... I want to use the right, the way she wrote it verbatim. That's not a gathering for innocent social enjoyment. So don't move from one extreme to the next. I'm just saying, guys, this is me talking to my fellow Adventists who I've noticed do stuff like this. Don't ostracize yourself from people and then want to evangelize to them.
That's a loveless evangelistic effort. You are disinterested in their interests, in their vocation. Like, you just really don't care about them, but you're trying to win them over. That doesn't make sense. If I was non-Adventist, non-acceptable in my mail, because it doesn't make sense. Why are you? Where's the love? Where is the love? Also, one other extreme is now just being liberal and like going to clubs or bringing club gathering and then saying you're meeting people where they are. Is it still a gathering of, in a sense, social enjoyment? Let's think about these things, guys. Let's think about these things, and I will see you guys on Thursday. Hopefully, this time I will see you on Thursday. Hey guys, morning. It is Thursday morning, the day we have all been waiting for, except everything that was going to happen today got cancelled. So, in retrospect, it is good that I had been babbling my mouth all the way through what? From Saturday all the way through to Tuesday. Was Tuesday the last day I was in your faces again? I don't remember. Maybe Monday. It was Monday. I think it was Monday. So it's a good thing, essentially, that I had been. But tomorrow, we will be going somewhere. We will be doing something. I will announce it on the day. Yeah. Tomorrow up until Sunday, it's going to be a bit eventful. So, yeah, guys. I guess we'll catch up then. Yeah, have to go to work. 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 Have to go to work. So I'll see you guys later.
This what happened when I think about you. I get in my feelings, yeah. I start reminiscing, yeah. Next time around, fuck, I want it to be different, yeah. Waiting on a sign, guess it's time for a different prayer. Lord, please save her for me. Do this one favor for me.
Morning, guys. Morning. It is Friday morning. I'm about to take a shower and wash my hair. I would have liked to show you the process, but I don't know. I'll show you the process next time. Next time it's been a while since I washed my own natural hair and like basically took real care of it, and by that I mean myself, because I usually go to the salon. In the past maybe 2 3 years, no, the past 4 years actually, I would usually just go to the salon and wash my hair and straighten my hair. Like, they would straighten my hair with the hair dryer and it just damaged my hair. Because, like I said in episode one, that wasn't good for my hair. There's one thing I know about my hair, it does not like heat like that. It loves shrinkage or a twist out. So, yeah. This is like day one of getting back to my normal natural hair care routine that I used prior to 2019. I'll show you guys pictures of what my hair looked like before 2019. It was glorious. It was gorgeous. So, I mean, take a shower, wash my hair, clean the house, and then I'll take you guys with me to go do my nails. So, yeah, guys, till then. Guys, I almost forgot about the haul. Fuck.
Funky brain. I just woke up. Before I take a shower, I am going to give you a yarn haul. So let's get to it. So I got this Aunt Jackie's Also Clean moisturizing and softening shampoo. I've been seeing a lot of natural hair influencers talking about it, the brand especially, Aunt Jackie's. So I was like, okay, let me try it. Let me see what it's about. It doesn't have sulfate. It doesn't have a lot of stuff that is damaging to natural hair. So that's great. Then I got the Native Child Deep Conditioning Deep Conditioner. It's vegan hair care. It also doesn't have sulfates and stuff, I think. I'll take a good read of this. So yeah, the one thing I haven't been doing to my hair is conditioning it, and that's all good. And then I got the Garnier Skincare Moisture Balm Sheet Mask. I definitely love that. It's infused with the quantity of one bottle of serum. So yeah, I said, let me try this. This looks like something I should try. So yeah. And you already know, I got myself that lovely perfume from Two Oaks, the perfume bar at Maseru Mall, opposite to Checkers. My scent is actually Gold Oud, guys. Last time I bought Seductive, only because I hadn't budgeted properly for Gold Oud, I think. So this month I said, give me my Gold Oud. Give me my Gold Oud. So I think that's it for my cosmetics haul.
Oh, guys, don't mind the mess. Don't mind the mess at the back. I'm trying to give you a haul. I'm not done with the haul yet. And I don't have a stand, so this is what we're gonna have to be dealing with as I give you hands-free content. I got this cute dress, this cute muscle shirt dress from Mr. Price. It's a long dress. Let me stop looking at myself. I will show you what it looks like when I have it on Sunday. So, it was on sale. And it's cute. I really don't like white clothes because, hey, it's a whole sewer, guys. It's a whole sewer. It's a lot of work. But for this dress, get out sewer. Okay? And then, yeah, that's all the clothes I got. And then I got underwear. I don't know if I should be showing people my underwear. But I got underwear. Yay! I will not expand on that point, but if you're a girl, you probably get why I'm excited about buying underwear. Okay, guys, that's the end of my haul. Let me go take a shower and then talk when I take you guys with me to go get my nails done. Yeah. Hey guys, I just finished taking a shower. Actually, I showered a while ago. It's been a while since I took a shower and washed my hair. I was just, oh, I have product residue in my hair, but it'll melt away. It's fine. Yeah, I was just cleaning the house. I am heading out now to go get my nails done. So let's go. Always thinking about what he wants and just dance on his blue gas. So don't die.
I took a chance on this primer. I don't know how it's gonna sit, I don't know how it's gonna feel, but I guess we'll find out tomorrow.
Morning, guys. It is Sabbath morning. The last time I spoke to you guys was the last time I addressed you guys at all was when I was getting my nails done, which I am so happy about. Like, hey guys, what about your camera? Struggle. Let me try to show you guys. Yeah, I'm so happy about my nails. Love that for me, Kesana. And I'm finally becoming a girl. I'm finally becoming a girl. I mean, it did come at some sacrifices. I had to make some budget cuts, but I was like, listen, so let me get something done. Also, I'm wearing my natural hair this month. I'm not getting it done, I'm just letting it breathe. So I honestly couldn't like just have my natural hair. I'm not saying my natural hair is ugly, but I needed to vamp up some areas, guys. You know, I also got my lashes done by my cousin Malifungheta. They're a bit on the dramatic side in terms of length, but in terms of length, they're on the dramatic side, but I like the volume. I like that it's not a lot. I like that it's not a lot going on. Let me see if you guys can see them clearly. Yeah, I see them. I like that it's not a lot. Low-key wishing I finished doing my laundry and it was already hanging. I left my laundry soaking in water yesterday at around 4 or 5 p.m. and I was just like, I'm too tired. This is my self-care day, so let them soak in there in soapy water and hopefully it will do it some good. It's my whites and beiges, so yeah, I'll finish that laundry up today after church, after Sabbath, after the Sabbath closes. Also, today is Zdasa Student Convention Day. Unfortunately, I will not be attending because Dibaja didin Rahil Shin Ding Tarakanse Ding Tasi Tseko. So I won't be able to attend the Zdasa Student Convention, but I really pray that God blesses the event. Also, I figured, you know, it's a student convention. I mean, it's okay. I feel like it's okay if I miss it because I'm no longer a student. But like the day they host a professional thing, I'm there. I am squeezing my buttocks to make sure I'm there. So I'm just gonna get ready for church. I'm going for normal church services at my church. What else did I want to say to you guys? I got my fridge fixed. Actually, my mentor borrowed me her fridge and yeah, guys, you can see it's already flipped out. My storage space is acting up again. Anyway, I just wanted to tell you guys that I got my fridge fixed. Actually, it's not my fridge. My mentor borrowed me her fridge. So yay for mentors. So I got my fridge fixed. Let me show you guys. The fridge is cold again because I didn't buy frozen produce or like
yeah, produce that needs to be refrigerated.
This is all I have. This is all I have
in my fridge.
I'm not even exaggerating. My freezer has nothing. But hey, let's hope I somehow find the money to stock that fridge up, because the girl's already broke. Your girl is already broke. I mean, what is adulting? What is adulting? But guys, I'm getting ready for church. I overslept today. So I need to get ready as quickly as possible. So, oh, also, my friend is in the country. She will be with me and my other friends tomorrow. It's gonna be a good time. I'm gonna show you some of my friends. So yeah, see you guys tomorrow, I think. Love you loads, kissan. Hey guys, I know I said I'll see you on Sunday, but by now, I'm a little dry longer. I'll keep popping up even before the time I say I'm gonna pop up. I'm with my friend.
Hey guys.
It's gonna be a good time. It's gonna be a fun time. Mm. I told you.
And tomorrow we got
Tomorrow is gonna be... Guys. But Gara, you know what? It's gonna be a good time.
But they must know, though. They must know that you are a very strong woman of God.
I've been saying.
Can someone put prayer requests there in the comments?
Prayer warrior.
She's this a girl. Prayer warrior.
I've been saying.
We will number it for you guys.
So, guys, we will see you tomorrow, maybe. I don't know. Or in the
I
next 5 minutes.
The dress.
Look at that outfit. Wait. Look at that outfit, guys. Is it not the cutest
I'm a
thing?
Cute purse. You were talking about Papa.
We'll see you tomorrow, guys.
에부에는
guy experience how I saw it.
The Sabbath isn't Sabbath, and I'm too far from home to have a Sabbath that's not Sabbath. I can understand. I can understand how is the Sabbath not Sabbath thing when I'm so far? When I've traveled a journey of 8 hours, 8.5 hours to get here, and the Sabbath is not Sabbath. Hey!
Yeah, Spider-Man and Freeze in full effect.
Uh-huh. You ready, Ron?
I'm ready.
You ready, Jill?
I'm ready, Slick. Are you?
Oh, yeah. Break it down.
Girl, I must warn you. I sense something strange in my mind. Yeah.
Morning, guys. I've only just gotten out of bed. It took me an hour 30 minutes to finally get out of bed. I'm about to clean the house, make breakfast, and get ready to leave. So yeah, guys, we'll talk to you guys when I'm done and ready. So guys, as you can tell by now, the kids are shopping in bits and pieces. I decided to try this Vaseline Intense Care Body Cream only because I felt like the Triform petroleum jelly wasn't working for me, because I would still feel very dry, you know, after using it. So let's see where this one takes me. Hey guys, I am done. I am ready to bounce. La sala. Oh. Guys, this dress I'm wearing, I don't know if the material is too, I think it's because the material is too light, but it is a bit see-through. Luckily, I'm wearing my nude underwear and nude bra, but like it's spotted, it's like a cheetah bra. So I don't know if people are gonna see what's going on. I wanna do a whole drip check, but equipment, don't have the Lekom equipment. So I'll take a picture and I'll probably put that picture as my thumbnail, like a picture of my entire outfit at the venue. That's famous.
London. Another banga, banga. From here, where's the water? You green body make I rock. Yeah. I know you seen your me. I get the money, pass your papa. Wait till you want way, I know feed do for you. Why you want the booga? Share you be kiss than any. You better drop your body. I'm a sucker. Suffer with this body. Make we run, I'm on a low.
Hey guys, hi. It is Tuesday morning. It is back to work. The lashes have started evacuating the premises, so it only means umlando uphelile. So it's back to work. As I was editing episode 7, I realized that I might need an outro, so this is it. I had a pretty decent weekend. It was nice. It was okay. I mean, it had greater potential, but it was okay. I went to MSU Market. I did everything I wanted to do. I was there for mocktails and trying out delicacies I've never tried before. I had a trout burger from the gin and trout stand. I hope I got it right. Yeah, gin and trout stand. Loved it. Even had some salmon eggs. I was talking about this Livelubilu, my friend, and I was like, what is this? She was like, this is salmon eggs. So I was like, so this is like caviar? And he's like, I'm like, okay, so this is like a cheaper version of caviar. She's like, yeah. So I had a cheaper version of caviar. I mean, if caviar, like actual caviar, tastes as much as it costs, then I get it. I get the hype, because the salmon eggs were nice. The salmon eggs were nice. So yeah, I had the trout burger. It was so nice. Made me consider switching to trout burgers like full time. Like no more beef burgers. I'm trying to wean myself off of red meat. And who knows, maybe eventually I'll stop eating chicken and I'll become pescatarian. So who knows? But guys, let me not get late for work. I'm already late. Because I mean, I'm so thrilled to be there. Like, I'm excited. I can't wait to get back to work. Anyways, let me love and leave you. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, do all those nice things. And yeah, guys.
From here, where's the water, you? Green body make I rock on.